When you're teaching online, you need to keep things simple for your students. That's why Zoom's new whiteboard is a great addition to the online classroom. Let's go take a look how it works and six ways you can use it in your classroom. Hi, my name's Charlie. This is my channel, Charlie's Lessons, and I've been using Zoom for over 4 years to teach English online. This year, Zoom has rolled out a lot of new features, and one of them is Zoom's new whiteboards. So what's new then? Let's go take a look. With Zoom's new whiteboards, you can create whiteboards pre-class. You can now collaborate on the same whiteboard with other teachers or students. And these whiteboards that you create before the class, you can access them immediately in class. Now, if you already know how to use Zoom whiteboards, then you can skip this next part and go straight to my ideas. But for those that don't, here is a quick tutorial on how to get set up with Zoom's new whiteboards. You can access Zoom's new whiteboard by going to the website Zoom, logging in, and on the left-hand side, there should be a big purple sign saying new next to whiteboards. And you can find the new whiteboards on the Zoom program by just opening the program, signing in, and you can see it in the top menu. This whiteboard feature has all the typical features that you would expect with a whiteboard. You can create text, lines, shapes, sticky notes, etc. One thing to note right now is that the options available to you when you're creating a whiteboard pre-class are not the same when you're in class. When you do start your meeting or your class online, then you'll see the whiteboard icon on the right-hand side. With Zoom, there are currently two whiteboards, both under the same name. If you go to screen share, you can then also open a whiteboard, but this is not the same as Zoom's new whiteboard. Do you get it? Zoom's original whiteboard does not have the features that are available on Zoom's new whiteboard. For example, when you start Zoom's original whiteboard via screen share, then you will not be able to see the students' cameras on the right-hand side. With Zoom's new whiteboard feature, the students or the people in the meeting with you will maintain their videos on the right-hand side. Before you start editing a new Zoom whiteboard in a live class, it will give you some options on whether you want the participants to either view or edit this whiteboard, and if the attendees can access this whiteboard after the meeting or the class. Before we go take a look at the six ideas, there's one more thing that's important to know. When you do create a whiteboard pre-class and load it up in class, some of the elements may not be exactly as you found them or exactly as you made them. I found that the text has the biggest problem. So some of the text boxes that you create may not be exactly in the same position as you left them. I'll put a link to all the whiteboards that I've made in the description so you can access them for your own class. Don't worry, it's no problem. The first way I've been using Zoom's new whiteboard is to help me set up the beginning of every class. When I teach, I always set up the whiteboard in the same way. On the right-hand side, I have a space for emergent vocabulary, so vocabulary that comes up randomly in the class. On the left-hand side, I've got the class menu, which is basically the objectives for the class. Then I've obviously got the date, and I've got the topic of the class. What I've done is I've created a very simple template and I can load this up for the beginning of every class and it saves me a lot of time. The second way I've been using Zoom's new whiteboard feature is to set up templates for typical games that I usually play with my students. One of my favorite games that I play with my students is Stop the Bus. Now, you might have a game like this, but with a different name. The way it works is that you have five categories and you have to choose a random letter and the students have to name one thing in each category that begins with that letter. So what I've done is I've created a template, which means I can load it up instantly in class and get playing. Zoom saves all the whiteboards that you create. So the third way I've been using it is to load up the previous class's whiteboard for the students to look at the beginning of the next class. This is a very good way to review what we've done in the previous class. So after I've explained to the students what we're doing for this class, I'll then load up the old whiteboard from the previous class and test my students' memory on what we studied in the previous class. Zoom's new feature allows you to collaborate or share whiteboards with other people. So this could be either teachers or students. The fourth way I've been using this is to set homework with my students. So I might create a whiteboard with a set of comprehension questions for a reading text or a listening that I've set them, and then they have to complete that whiteboard with their answers. You can make individual whiteboards for each student, or if you'd like them to work together on something, you can share the same whiteboard with a group of students. Always remember to let them edit it, not just view. When I'm teaching online or face-to-face, I often get absent students. I'm looking at you, Pedro. So this new feature where I can share the whiteboard is really useful. This is my fifth idea. So what I do is when we have a class and that student is missing, I'll save the whiteboards and I'll share them with that student. I can either do this by email, or if we're using an LMS like Google Classroom, I can export the whiteboard and upload it to the LMS that you're using and share it directly with the student. My last idea, and idea number six, is to get students to present a language area to the class. Now, I often do this with phrasal verbs, especially in a face-to-face classroom. And what I do is I assign a phrasal verb from a particular topic, let's say travel, and I would like that student to go home and present to the class in the next class how that phrasal verb works. They need to talk about, is it inseparable or separable? What is the meaning of that phrasal verb? And an example sentence. And I created a template for this whiteboard in my Zoom account. The way this works, much like setting homework, is I will share that template with each individual student, and then the next class, they will have to then present this to the class and go through all the different aspects of the phrasal verb. Thank you for watching. I hope that you can use some of these ideas in your classroom using Zoom's new whiteboard feature. I'll see you in the next video.